يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار ليجزيهم الله بما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله ليجزي الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله والله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب الله سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا الله سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله الله أكبر الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله آجو عزیز دوستو تھوڑے سے قریب آجو تھوڑے سے دیر ہم یہ بہترین السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ مائی ڈیئر برادرز اینڈ سسٹرز السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ If my memory serves me right, I remember coming here a year ago maybe. More than that, because I remember this masjid, mashallah. And I remember last time when I was here, it was I think Jummah. And I remember, mashallah. And even now, gives me a lot of pleasure to see that, you know, mashallah, so many people have gathered. May Allah Rabbul Izzat bless you all. My Sheikh, Sheikh Hasan Abu Nahr, inshallah, Ba'da Isha, my request is to all of you, that please sit down before Ba'da Isha, and we have a small project. And by as much as Allah gives tawfiq, do make a contribution to it. And you will be very happy to hear the kind of work that, by Allah's grace, we are doing all over the world. So before Isha, let me just have a few words with all of you. Some of the words that I get to hear from our elders, and may it help all of us. My dear brothers, I was reading one of the bayans of Maulana Yusuf Sahab Rahimullah. He was one of our elders in the work of Tabligh. People in this masjid, do you have an idea what this work of Tabligh is, right? Yeah? Most of you, mashallah. So it was something that I heard, and when I read it, I couldn't sleep the whole night. After reading his bayan, I couldn't sleep the whole night. I had tears in my eyes for the rest of the night. And I just kept on thinking that whether what all I've been doing in my life, whether it was acceptable in the eyes of Allah or whether it was not acceptable in the eyes of Allah. So these are some of the words that he said, and I'll narrate them to you. He said, if the direction of your effort in your life, if the direction of the effort that you make in your life, if the direction is right, he said, you don't need to make too much effort. By making little effort, Allah will give you what all you want from Allah. Allah will give you everything if the direction of your effort is right. Agar aapki juhd ka rasta seedha hai, agar aapki juhd ka rasta seedha hai, to bahut thodi mehnat par wo sab kuch mil jayega jiski Allah se tamanna karte hain aap aur main. And then he said, if the direction is not right, you will end up making so much effort and the gains will be very little. Right? The gains will be... Peeche nahi aa rahi awaaz? What about now? Ab theek hai? So what is the most important thing? وَأَلَّيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. You will get only according to the effort that you make. This is the rule of Allah in this world. Bachcha roye nahi to maa doodh bhi nahi pilati. So the child also has to make that particular effort. But is my effort in the right direction? Is my effort what is required of me? Is it making Allah happy? Or am I basically just wasting my time in this world? You remember, we have any engineers or college students sitting here, you will know that when we used to do our papers, the questions and the numericals that we used to get, answer was not the most important thing. Method, how did you do this? How did you arrive to this answer? The teacher always used to see the method of the numerical. This is what I remember studying in Pakistan in my pre-engineering times, So my teacher used to say, answer is not important. If your answer is incorrect, you'll probably just lose half a mark or maybe one mark. I will only see the method. And if your method is incorrect, even if your answer is right, you're going to get zero out of it. So, like there was this Sahabi. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is sitting amongst his Sahaba Ikram, and there is this Sahabi. Before he enters the masjid, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, a jannati is about to enter the masjid. So all the sahabas, their priority was always the akhira. So they were like, who is about to enter the masjid? So they see an Ansari sahabi, he walks in and he has no idea that the Prophet of Allah just says something like this. So he came in, he put his shoes somewhere, water was dripping off his body, the wuzu that he had performed. He came and he sat in one part of the masjid. And salah went. Second day, similarly, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam again said, a jannati is about to enter the masjid. Sahaba immediately turned around and they saw the same sahabi entering, and this happened three times. After the third time, there was this Sahabi who was the son of Hazrat Amr bin al-As, his name was Abdullah. He said to himself, I fast the whole day and I do Qiyamul Layl almost the whole night and I'm doing it every day. How come the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam never said something like this to me? I have to see what this Mawlana or what this Sahabi does. I have to go and find out. So he came out of the masjid and he said, Hazrat, I have a little dispute with my father and I'm not going home. Can I spend three nights at your house? He said, Ahlan wa sahlan, most welcome, come in. Direction of effort. Direction of effort. So he goes in to his house. And when he sleeps, at night, Abdullah bin Amr, he just removes his blanket a little just to see what is this uncle of mine doing.
So this Ansari Sahabi, as the night begins, Badr Isha, he goes to his bed. Allahumma bismika amutu wa ahya, and he goes to sleep. And he sleeps the whole night. And he is, trying to see what is he doing the whole night. And when the azan of Fajr comes in, he just wakes up, Alhamdulillah allazi ahyana ba'da ma amatana wa ilayhin nushur. Da goes, performs his wudu, goes to the masjid. He says he slept the whole night. Where is the tahajjud? And then he tries to follow him the whole day. He's just like a normal person. If he has to go for his business, he goes for his business. If he has to do other things, he does other things. He says, probably next day he'll do something even more strenuous. Second day again, Allahumma bismaka amutu wa ahya, and goes to sleep. Exactly the same thing. And the third night, exactly the same thing. So after the third night, a young man, he is just brimming of wanting to know what the hell is going on. And he says, Ya Hazrat, oh my uncle, please. Three times you came to the masjid, and I was sitting with the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Three times he said, a jannat is coming into the masjid. What is the direction of your effort? You slept the whole night. I am in Qiyamul Layl the whole night. You did not even fast during the day. I fast every day. I never got this Basharat from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the direction of your effort? What do you do? He said, oh my son, nothing like that. I am just like every other normal person. No, there must be, but I don't know. Okay, I'm leaving. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. So as he was about to leave, the Ansari Sahabi said, oh my son, stop. Come back. He said, yes, I don't seem to understand. I don't do all these efforts that most of the people do. But I do one thing. I do one thing, and that is that before going to sleep every night, I forgive everyone. Abdullah bin Amr bin Al-As immediately just said, Allahu Akbar. He couldn't hold it. He said, That's it. This is something that you do and I don't do it, or we don't do it. This is the direction of effort. The right direction of effort, in which you don't have to do much, and Allah is already giving you paradise. तो हमारा कसूर हमें यही नहीं पता हमने मेहनत करनी किधर है. मेहनत का मैदान मैं खुद हूं. I have to make effort on myself. मैं हूं मेहनत का मैदान, और मुझे हर एक में बुराई नजर आती है. ये सब बुरे हैं, मैं कितना अच्छा हूं. So my dear brothers, very, very important. This is very, very important. कि मेरी मेहनत का मैदान क्या है? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes through 3 days of hunger. 3 days of hunger. He is Sarvar Kaunain, Sardar Do Jahan, the leader of the entire mankind. Yeah? The leader of Sakalain. 3 days of hunger. So what does he do? He comes to the masjid. He comes to the masjid and he prays. And goes back to the house and asks
His beloved wife, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Aisha, did Allah send something for us to eat? She said, no. And he comes back to the masjid. And he prays again. And he prays again, makes dua, goes back to his house. Did Allah send something for us to eat? Ya Rasulullah, not as yet. He comes back again to the masjid. Three times. When he goes back, Sayyidina Aisha says, Ya Rasulullah, Usman came and brought this much meat and this much bread. And he said, next time the Prophet of Allah, if ever he goes through this situation, please inform me. So the Prophet of Allah said, Ya Aisha, why did you not tell Usman that, oh Usman, you did not send something to eat. Allah sent it to us. Now, it was enough for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to just pray once. And all the khazain of the entire universe would have been in his house. But just to teach you and me, what is the right direction? What is the right direction? That salah will solve our problems. Now when we say this, wallah, believe me, when we say this even amongst our Muslim brothers, most of the people think, what is this man talking about? If I don't believe that the salah of mine is going to get me food for 2 days, how do I expect to get this Jannah from my five times salah? Agar mujhe do roti ke milne ki umeed nahi apni namaz se, to mujhe jannat kahan se mil jayegi is namaz se? Allah ke nabi ka irshad hai na, namaz jannat ki kunji hai. Kaise ye kaise ho gaya? Mujhe to is namaz se apna ek masla bhi hal hota hua nazar nahi aata. Aapko ehsaas hai hum kitne dur hain? How far we are from it? How far? Main apni baat kar raha hu. Wallah, I'm talking about myself. Ki mujhe apni namaz se apne masail ka hal nazar nahi aa raha. 5 basharats that the Prophet of Allah gave. Number 1, Allah will solve all your problems of your risk. Don't miss your salah deliberately. When you die, you go into the qabr. Allah will make your stay in qabr, will take all the azab away. Don't miss your 5 times salah. Number 3, on the day of qiyamah in mahshar, Allah Rabbul Izzat will give your namai amal in your right hand. Do not miss your 5 times salah. On the bridge of Sirat, Allah will make you go like in a jiffy, and like lightning. Don't miss your 5 times salah deliberately. And when you will stand in front of Allah, Allah Rabbul Izzat Allah will give you Jannah without any hisab. Don't miss your 5 times salah. Even today when we talk about it, ask yourself, and I ask myself, do I actually believe in what I'm hearing right now? This is how far my effort is from the right direction. Wallah, believe me, the Prophet of Allah won the battle of Badr through his salah. Yes, Sulaiman alayhi salam got his kingdom because of his salah. Isa alayhi salam got his food because of his salah. Musa alayhi salam went to Pharaoh, and Musa alayhi salam gave his dawat, and Allah gave him success because of his salah. Aaj yakin nahi hai na is baat ka, isliye apni namaz par koi mehnat nahi hai. Apni namaz par koi mehnat nahi hai, khayal bhi nahi aata. I came to know about this only yesterday, and since yesterday I was just thinking, are there any doctors sitting here? Any doctors sitting here? I was yesterday with a friend of mine who's a doctor, and he said, Brother Junaid, in these times, for somebody to be a surgeon, He has to clear an exam every year to remain a surgeon, a practicing surgeon. If he's a surgeon even for 30 years in the US, he has to give an exam every day, every year. I couldn't believe it. कि मैंने कहा देखो देखो इसको इसकी मेडिसिन पे कितनी मेहनत करा रहे हैं, इस डॉक्टर से कितनी मेहनत करा रहे हैं, how much effort are they making this doctor do even though he's a surgeon for the last 30 years. और आज मेरी नमाज, my salah, which is going to solve every single problem of mine, my salah, I am not ready to make any effort on it. ये मेरी नमाज अल्लाह के हाँ मेरे मामलात को हल कराएगी कि नहीं कराएगी? You remember that time when that man came to Sayyidina Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala and he said to him, Hazrat, your house is burning. He said, no, my house cannot be burning. He said, Hazrat, your house is burning. He said, no, that's not possible. The third man came, your house is burning. He said, it's not possible. The fourth man came and said, Abu Darda, actually the fire was pretty vicious. It was coming to your house, but by the time it came to your house, it just fizzled out, extinguished. He says, I knew it. But how come? He said, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had taught me a dua. I actually read that dua in the morning. So I knew everything, my life, my ahl, my family, my wealth, everything is saved. Aaj yakeen aata hai is baat par? Yakeen aata hai aaj is baat par? Are nahi aata. Dil nahi manta is baat par. I was in 4 months in Raivind and I was listening to a bayan of one of the elders and he said, we go out in the path of Allah and we praise Allah and we praise the Prophet of Allah so that my heart starts believing that Allah will solve my problem. The day this thing is going to go inside me, from that day onwards, my du'as will become powerful. So we go out in the path of Allah and sit with our elders so that our du'as become powerful. Hum is raaste mein nikalte isliye hain ki taaki Allah hamari du'aon ko taqatwar bana de. Main jab du'a mangu to mujhe yaqeen ho ki meri du'a qubool hogi. Tab to duniya mein rehne ka maza hai na. Tab to دنیا میں رہنے کا مزہ ہے جب اس بات کا یقین ہو کہ دعا نے قبول ہو جانا ہے, ورنہ دنیا میں رہنے کا کیا مزہ ہے, کیا مزہ ہے دنیا میں رہنے؟ صبح ہوتی ہے, شام ہوتی ہے, زندگی جو ہی تمام ہوتی ہے. When I know that when I will raise my hands and when I will make my dua, this dua will be accepted. یہ ہر حالت میں یہ دعا قبول ہوگی. May Allah make this life such beautiful for us. اذان ابھی کریں گے یار, جس نے پڑھنی بولنی ہے اس کو تو کرنے دو, تم کہاں سے بیچ میں بولے یار. 8 بجے کر لینا اذان, پھر کھڑا کر دینا, انہیں پرابلم نہیں, آپ کو پرابلم ہے. ہاں ہاں 8 بجے نماز پڑھیں گے, سارے پریشان مت ہو, نماز سب کی ہوگی. اس مسجد میں آگے ہو تو پڑھ بھی لوگے, ٹھیک ہے جی؟ 8:15 سنا ہے کہ 8 بجے پڑھیں گے, 8 بجے پڑھیں گے, ٹھیک ہے, 8 بجے پڑھیں گے, اذان دے کر کھڑے ہو جائیں گے, ٹھیک ہے. پھر انشاءاللہ شیخ بات کریں گے اذان کے, عشاء کے بعد. تو میرے عزیز دوستو, مائی ڈیئر برادرز, پلیز تھنک اباؤٹ اٹ. And trust me, Allah will make this life so beautiful for you. Make an effort on your salah. Kisi Allah wale ko namaz padh ke dega, Hazrat meri namaz bataiye kaisi hai. Aur raaton ko sone se pehle sabko maaf karke sona hai. Karenge aise? Haan. Lekin agar rishtedaron mein karenge to naak kat jayegi. Ab kya kare? ہاں اب کیا کریں, अगर चाचे के बेटे को माफ कर दिया तो मेरी नाक कट जाएगी। सबसे बड़ा बहादुर वो है जो अपने रिश्तेदारों के साथ अच्छा ताल्लुक रखता है, दोस्तों के साथ नहीं। दोस्तों की तो जरूरत पड़ती है, नॉट जस्ट विद योर फ्रेंड्स बट विद योर रिलेटिव्स। रिश्तेदारों के साथ जो अच्छा ताल्लुक रखता है वो सबसे बड़ा बहादुर है। खाला की बेटी को तलाक हो गई, खाला की बेटी को तलाक हो गई, आखिरी बार आपने कब उस बेचारी को पैसे भेजे घर? फूफी की बेटी को तलाक हो गई, तीन बच्चे हैं उसके, आखिरी बार कब पैसे भेजे उसको? चचा का लड़का लॉस्ट हिज जॉब, अच्छा हुआ नीचे रहे हमसे तो बेहतर है, आखिरी बार कब पूछा उसको तेरी रात और दिन कैसे गुजर रहे हैं? मेरे अजीज दोस्तों, ये वक्त का बहादुर है जो ये काम कर रहा है। अब दुआ मांगो, मैं देखता हूं कैसे कबूल नहीं होती। एफर्ट इन द राइट डायरेक्शन, अल्लाह विल मेक योर लाइफ अ सोर्स ऑफ हिदायत फॉर एवरीवन। पीपल विल एनवी योर ब्यूटिफुल लाइफ। ठीक है, इन लोगों को पैसे देना बहुत अच्छा है, ये जो काम कर रहे हैं बहुत अच्छा है, लेकिन पहला हकदार आपके चचा का लड़का है, आपके ताया की बेटी है, ये पहले हकदार हैं। आपका भाई है, आपकी बहन है, ये पहले हकदार हैं। कब पूछा इनको? आखिरी मतलब तो इन बातों का ख्याल रखिए। अमेरिका में रहेंगे आपकी औलाद, अल्लाह इसको ऐसे ट्रेन करेगा ये आपकी आंखों की ठंडक बन जाएगी, अगर ना बनी तो गर्दन पकड़ लेना मेरी आंख। In 2005, I remember. 2006, I remember. You know, when I had left music, I really had nothing else. I was very going through a very tough time in life because that was my livelihood. So a jamaat was made, and we for 7 months to go to Europe. So my Amir came to me and he said, "You have to come." I said, "Sheikh, it's a very difficult for me. You know, I have a young wife and my children, and I have no really source." He said, make this niyat. O Allah, I am going in your path for the betterment of the children of my fellow Muslim brothers. You take care of my children and read this dua. What is this dua? Sheikh, if I make a mistake, help me. Allahumma hawwin alayna safarana haza watwi anna bu'da. اللهم انت الصاحب في السفر والخليفه في الاهل. What beautiful words. واعوذ بك من وصاء السفر وكعابه المنظر وسوء المنقلب والمال والاهل والورد. Make this dua right now and come with me, and then see how Allah will make your children like the coolness of your eyes. To bacche hum thodi train karte hain, हम बच्चे ट्रेन करते हैं, हमसे क्या बच्चे ट्रेन हो सकते हैं? तुम्हारे पर वक्त की तरह तुम लोगों को बच्चे ट्रेन करने का। तुम अल्लाह के फरमा बरदार बनो, अल्लाह इनको तुम्हारा फरमा बरदार बना देगा। सौ फीसद ऐसा ही होगा। मैं अल्लाह का नाफरमान, मेरी औलाद मेरी नाफरमान। मैं अल्लाह को वक्त नहीं देता, वो मुझे वक्त नहीं देते। Effort in the right direction, my dear brothers. बस ये मेरी आपसे दरख्वास्त है। And then you won't have to do much. थोड़ा ही करोगे, इतना करोगे, इतने रिजल्ट मिलेंगे। वरना इतना करोगे, ये इतना रिजल्ट मिलेगा, इतना सा रिजल्ट मिलेगा। करते करते पूरी जिंदगी ख्वार हो जाओगे, कुछ हाथ नहीं आएगा। ये मैं अपनी जिंदगी का तजर्बा बता रहा हूं आपको, क्योंकि मैंने आई हैव सीन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द रोड। ये इधर भी देखा है और इधर भी देखा है। आई हैव सीन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द रोड। मेहनत उधर भी बहुत की, बहुत मेहनत की उधर भी। हां, एंड today I have absolutely no remnants of that life. I can't see. Sometimes people come up to me and they tell me that, you know, we saw you 15 years ago, 20 years ago in that concert. I just blankly look at their face because I don't remember anything of the past. Because it really wasn't worthwhile for me to remember anything in that part of my life. So probably Allah has just taken that chip out of it. And look, when I come back, the moment I entered this masjid, all the flashbacks just came back. And I remember, oh yes, it was a Friday when I came here. And I remember the people. I remember this gentleman's face who was sitting over here. And there are two, three other faces I remember. When I saw them, I remembered even the faces. Ki maine inka bhi chehra dekha, iska bhi chehra dekha. तो बुराई का सबसे बड़ा नुकसान क्या है? बुराई का सबसे बड़ा नुकसान क्या है कि उसका मजा थोड़ी देर का होता है और वबाल हमेशा का होता है. और नेकी की सबसे बड़ा अजर क्या है कि उसकी जोहद शुरू में थोड़ी सी होती है लेकिन उसका अजर हमेशा का होता है. बुराई आपको जब याद आएगी, आप मुसलमान की औलाद हो, बुराई जब भी याद आएगी, whenever you will remember something wrong that you've done, you will feel bad inside your heart. नेकी जब भी याद आएगी, whenever you will remember a good deed that you have performed, you will always feel good inside your heart. That's the difference. Allah bless you all for sitting here and listening to me. Because I had come from so far away. Wallah, believe me, I've really come from so far away. This friend of mine was about to kill us all, you know. The way he was driving on the motorway. Allah saved us. But I'm so happy, so glad to be here. Now we can do our azan. And Ba'da's azan, our sheikh is here. Please. Sit us. Give us 10 minutes Ba'da Isha. Allah bless you all. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika. Wa shahadu Allah ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حيا على الصلاة. حيا على الصلاة. حيا على الفلاح. حيا على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة. قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استقيم إلى الصلاة أرحمنا وإياكم الله أعتدل تراص رحم الله عبدا ساو نفسا. Make the line straight, brothers and sisters. Be close to each other. Don't leave any gap. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. و
وقل رب أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين وأعوذ بك رب أن يحضرون حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت قال رب ارجعون قال رب ارجعون لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها ومن ورائهم برزخ إلى يوم يبعثون فإذا نفخ في الصور فلا أنساب بينهم يومئذ ولا يتساءلون فمن ثقلت موازينه فأولئك هم الفائزون ومن خفت موازينه فأولئك الذين خسروا أنفسهم في جهنم خالدون تلفح وجوههم النار وهم فيها كالحون تلفح وجوههم النار وهم فيها كالحون ألم تكن آياتي تتلى عليكم فكنتم بها تكذبون قالوا ربنا غلبت علينا شقوتنا وكنا قوما ضالين ربنا أخرجنا منها فإن عدنا فإنا ظالمون قال اخسئوا فيها ولا تكلمون الله سمع الله لمن حمدا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إنه كان فريق من عبادي يقولون ربنا آمنا فاغفر لنا وارحمنا وأنت خير الراحمين فاتخذتموهم سخريا حتى أنسوكم ذكري وكنتم منهم تضحكون إني جزيتهم اليوم بما صبروا أنهم هم الفائزون قال كم لبثتم في الأرض عدد سنين قالوا لبثنا يوما أو بعض يوم فاسأل العادين قال إن لبثتم إلا قليلا لو أنكم كنتم تعلمون أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبثا أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبثا وأنكم إلينا لا ترجعون فتعالى الله الملك الحق لا إله إلا هو رب العرش الكريم الله الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته My respected brothers, inshallah, it will not be long, not more than inshallah 12-13 minutes, inshallah ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he went out after dhuhr. When he went out of his house, in the time of dhuhr, until now in Saudi Arabia, no one goes out of dhuhr. Out of dhuhr is the time of qailula. If somebody goes out of dhuhr, means something happened. So he saw Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Then he asked him, Ya Abu Bakr, what caused you to be out of your house this time? He said, Al-ju' Ya Rasulullah, the hunger. Allahu Akbar. They go out of their houses because of hunger. How about you, Ya Rasulullah? He said, Wallahi, the same reason what you have, I went out of my house. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu came. Then they asked him the same thing. What caused you to go out of your house, Ya Umar? He said, Ya Rasulullah, the hunger. How about you? He said, Wallahi, we are the same. They go out of their houses because there is no food. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Let us go to Jabir. Jabir, mashallah, he used to have some lambs in his house. Jabir was not in the house. So his wife said, Marhaban bi duyufina, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Umar al-Khattab, Bahlan wa sahlan, Ya marhaban. So when he came and saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his house, he said, MashaAllah, Nabiullah is my guest. So he took the knife. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Avoid the one who has milk. Ijtanib al-halub means don't slaughter the one who has milk. So he slaughtered a small lamb for them. He cooked it and he presented it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took a piece of meat and he said, Take this to Fatima, the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, she did not eat since 3 days. Allahu Akbar. The daughter of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bintu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She did not eat for 3 days, ya ikhwan. So why I am saying this, ya ikhwan? Because this dunya, if there is khair in this dunya, Allah will give it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, wallahi. This dunya is just time passing very fast. 2 years ago, Brother Javed, he is pilot. And Alhamdulillah, Brother Junaid Jamshed, he is with us now. We started a project, great project. The project what we have, we are digging wells for the needy people in Pakistan. They drink the dirty water. People, they boil the water. The animals and the people, they drink from the same sources. They boil the water and they give it to their children. To the point that the worms start going out of their ears and from their belly buttons. And people, they lose their children one after another. A man said, Wallahi al-Azim, I buried 4 of my children because of this water. Four. And alhamdulillah, Allah Azza wa Jalla gave us ni'mah that our children, they just drink sip of the water and they throw the bottle in the garbage. MashaAllah, beautiful water what we have. So alhamdulillah, we are the only people doing the solar system, because that area, Nuri Abad beside Karachi now, they have no electricity. People before the land, before the history, people, they have nothing. Sky and the earth. No electricity, so alhamdulillah, we start making the solar system, create the electricity. Alhamdulillah, the pumps work because of these solar system. Alhamdulillah, we reached down there and the problem up to 500 feet, the water is still contaminated. 500 feet because of these companies. They throw the chemicals 500 feet. If you dig up to 500 feet, still the water dirty. So alhamdulillah, we start digging 700, 800, 900 feet. And alhamdulillah, Allah Azza wa Jal gives us 18, 20 layers of water will fit the people about 80, 90 years. 90 years of water, sadaqa jariya. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, ya ikhwan, bifadlillah ta'ala, in 14 months, we covered 70,000 people. Now they are drinking from our wells. Takbir, takbir, takbir. Ya ikhwan, the well, all this work, the well cost $5,000. When my son and your son becomes 20, 21 years old, I will buy him a car, the decent car, $7,000, $8,000. So this is the real sadaqa jariya. Sa'ad bin Ubadah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when his mother died, he said, Ya Rasulullah, what's the best way to treat my mother, to give sadaqa jariya for my mother? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do sadaqa. Sadaqa jariya. He said, what kind of sadaqa, Ya Rasulullah? He said, khayru sadaqatil ma'. The best sadaqa is the water. Sa'ad radiallahu anhu dug well for his mother. Ya ikhwan, guess what? After 1400 years, still the mother of Sa'ad well working in Medina al-Munawwara. 1400 years in his parents' skin. Myself, my mother, rahmatullah ta'ala alayha, died 5 months ago. May Allah Azza wa Jal forgive her and forgive our parents, all of us, inshallah, all the deceased of Muslimin, ya Rabbi. Say ameen. May Allah accept them, ya Rabbi al-Alamin. I am not wealthy man. I made well for my parents. I told Brother Javed, I will pay it in installments. $5,000. Wallahi, ya ikhwan, wallahi al-azim. I paid it in period of time, I did not even feel it. And subhanallah, I have one of my children, he has eczema. The last child, he has eczema. I tried all the medicine, and I am myself no in hikmat. Kind of hakim. You can say neem hakim. Neem hakim khatra ijan, neem mulla khatra iman. So be careful from those two. So I know hikmat. I know. My father hakim, my grandfather hakim. My grandfather lived 127 years. No, even one of his teeth fell down. But I tried all medicine on this child, did not work. It minimized, it comes back. The moment Brother Javed told me the well start working, Allah cured my son. Wallahi, ya ikhwan. So this is the sadaqa jariya, ya ikhwan. We are leaving. Wallahi, we are leaving after 100 years. All of us, where will be? Where we will be? In the qubur. After 100 years, I will remember this moment. You remember this moment. What do I wish in that time? I say, Ya Rab, please bring me back to dunya. Let me give sadaqa jariya. It will be too late, ya ikhwan. Too late. So, ya ikhwan, $5,000. Sadaqa jariya, complete well. Complete well. You know the well, how many people fit? The well takes care of whole village. 700 families, their wudu, their salah, their siyam in your scale, their qiyamul layl in your scale. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the day of judgment, the Nabi will come with one man with him. Some anbiya will come with two men with him. Some anbiya will come, no one with him. And when you come in the day of judgment, there is villages behind you. 400 years, they are drinking clean water, making salah, wudu, qiyamul layl. Alhamdulillah, last night I was in Darul Quran Masjid. 11 brothers, they sponsored 11 wells. Takbir. Takbir. I wish, inshallah, from this Mubarak Majma'ah to have 7 wells. Bi'idhnillah. Already I have, alhamdulillah, 2 brothers. Takbir. 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 May Allah Azza wa Jal for my 2 brothers, their parents, their wives, their family, grant them al-Firdaws al-A'la. Say Ameen. May Allah Rabbil Izzat, Ya Rabbil Alameen, accept the Sadaqah Jariyah for them and their family. Say Ameen. Ya Rabbil Alameen, this is the last 2 nights of Muharram al-Haram. May Allah accept their Sadaqah in this Mubarak month, Ya Arham al-Rahameen. Say Ameen. Who's number 3 will meet Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala with another will? MashaAllah. Takbir. MashaAllah, I have my brother here. Another will, may Allah Azza wa Jalla grant him, his family, his parents, his children, al-Firdaws al-A'la. Say Ameen. Alhamdulillah, we have the brother here, mashallah. Who is number 5? I have number 5 and 6, mashallah. Brother Khalid. Jaldi, jaldi. Jaldi, jaldi. We have 2 brothers here, yeah. These 2 brothers, mashallah. This is your son, so you are one, both of them. MashaAllah, you see, alhamdulillah, the father and the son, they raise their hands, MashaAllah. We have number 5. And we have number 6? Do we have number 6? I have, MashaAllah, my brother here, brother Khalid. We have the brother here, MashaAllah. Takbir. For those 2 brothers, and we have number 7 there, MashaAllah. MashaAllah, takbir. Those 7 brothers, say Ameen. Ya Rabbil Alameen, in this last Mubarak night of Muharram, may Allah let them go to Jannah with their families without Hisab, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Say Ameen. May Allah Rabbil Izzat give them their Kitab without Hisab. Tell them, listen, take your Kitab, you look at it yourself. Say Ameen. We need another 3 wills to make them 10, inshallah, like last night. Who? Those people, may Allah gather them with 10 Mubashirin bil Jannah. Say Ameen. I have 7 brothers, 7 wells. We need another 3 brothers. Or maybe 3 sisters. We have, mashallah, number 8, takbir. May Allah grant you and your family Firdaws al-A'la. Say Ameen. Number 9. I told you, by the way, I will take 13 minutes. I will stick to 13 minutes. Maulanas, when they catch the microphone, they forget themselves. They take 1 hour. I will take 13 minutes. We need the last 2 people. MashaAllah, may Allah accept it, ya ikhwan. Wallahi, the poor people, they are the upper hands. When you give sadaqah, you should go kiss the hands of the poor people that they accept it. Imagine all the people, the poor people, they refuse our sadaqah. What will happen? What should I do with my zakat? By the way, alhamdulillah, we are 501c. You can take it out of your taxes. You can consider it from your zakat. You can use your credit card. Alhamdulillah, all options are there, inshallah. We need the last 2 people. In the day of judgment, he will say, Ya Rab, I was in Majma' and I am one of the last 2 people donated will fi sabilik. Inshallah, Allah will accept it. Say Ameen. Who are those 2 people? I can feel there is 2 people, they want to do it, but they have hesitation. You know what they say in Urdu? I have one of them, mashallah, takbir. MashaAllah, number 9 here. Say Ameen. May Allah grant him, his parents, his family, al-Firdaws al-A'la, ya Rabbi. Say Ameen. For those donors, may Allah make their children muttaqin salihin. I have number 10 there, mashallah. Takbir. Brothers, whosoever raise his hand, already the malaika wrote your name, inshallah. May Allah accept it. Please write your name, phone number, and give us the pledge back. We have, alhamdulillah, 10 people, 10 wills. Say Ameen. For those 10 people, Ya Rabbil Alameen, make their children muttaqin salihin. May Allah protect them, their families, from all the trials in dunya and akhirah. Say Ameen. To make it easy, how many of you willing to have half of the will? Means half of the village in your scale. Some people, they cannot make 5,000 for the will. They can make half of it. Can we see 2 people to sponsor 1 will? Fi sabilillah. May Allah accept it, inshallah. I have my brother here. Takbir. MashaAllah. May Allah accept it, inshallah. May Allah grant him and his family for those. Say Ameen. Who will complete the will? May Allah complete his iman. Takbir. I have my brother here, mashallah, he is completing the will. May Allah complete your darajat in Jannah. Say Ameen. May Allah accept it, sadaqah jariyah from you and the family. Say Ameen. Yes, raise your hand, please. We need another 2 people, another well fi sabirillah. Another will, two people. They will take half and half, mashallah. I have the brother there, mashallah, behind you here, mashallah. May Allah accept it, say ameen. May Allah grant you al-fan fi dawsa, say ameen. Who will complete the other will? May Allah complete his darajat in dunya and akhirah, inshallah. May Allah complete his iman. May Allah protect him, his parents, his family, from adab al-qabr, ya rabbal alameen. From adab al-hashr, ya rabbal alameen. May Allah let them go to al-jannah without hisab. Ya ikhwan, these last nights of Muharram, inshallah, the dua is mustajab. May Allah accept it, inshallah. We need another man to complete the other will fi sabilillah. Who is this man? May Allah accept it, inshallah. You know what? Because the time is running, and I have to catch it. Ya ikhwan, $1,000. Divided by 365 days, it's only $2.74 a day. If we sacrifice Dunkin' Donut 3 times a week, we will make it. $2.74 a day, $1,000 can feed 100 families for 90 years of water. 100 families, not persons. How many of you willing to give Allah qurda hasana $1,000? How many? Only $1,000. MashaAllah, I have one brother, MashaAllah. Takbir, may Allah accept it, inshallah. Who's number two? Sisters, you can do sadaqa jariya, inshallah. $1,000 lillah.
من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا.
Who is willing to give Allah قرض حسنا? You know what means قرض حسنا? You give Allah today, Allah will give you tomorrow when you are so need for it. I have only 1 minute left. I have, mashallah, another man there, mashallah. Brother Javed, where is Brother Khalid? Brother Khalid, where did he go? MashaAllah, we have the brother there. Please raise your hand again. MashaAllah, Brother Khalid, we have the brother there. Please give him pledge. Raise your hand, please. We need only three people, 3,000, and I will release you from my headache. Inshallah. Three people. You know, Brother Junaid, MashaAllah, I have brother there. MashaAllah, takbir, jazakallah khair. Ya Shaykh, give some brothers to help you. MashaAllah, we have, MashaAllah, people. MashaAllah, may Allah accept it. Say ameen. I was, Brother Junaid, I teach him Tajweed, and he teach me Urdu. Okay? So sometimes he make mistake and I pick on him. So he was waiting for opportunity to take his revenge. So I told him sometimes the people, by the way, this is not from my time, this is out of the time, this is pause, okay? So he is waiting for opportunity to take revenge from me. Because every time I said, no. I told him, some people, they want to do something, but they have hesitation. What do you say in Urdu? So he said, we say, Dil mein aa rahi hai, chijak se aa rahi hai. He said, okay, repeat it. Of course, the first time I will make mistake. So I said, Dil mein aa rahi hai, chijak se aa rahi. He said, no, your tajweed here is wrong. MashaAllah, he took revenge from me. I said, okay, so how to fix it? He said, do you know the machine gun? I said,
what?
A'udhu billah. He said, Dil mein aa rahi hai, sata rahi hai. I said, you know. From that time, alhamdulillah, he is very good muallim, mashallah. I never forget it. When I reach Dil mein aa rahi hai, I remember. So may Allah make my check to bring your check. Say ameen. We need the last person to give 1,000 lillah. Khatam. Khitamuhum is, who's making khatam tonight fi sabirillah? May Allah accept it, inshallah. Say ameen. I have my brother here. Takbir. By the way, ya ikhwan, if you have the ability to give $500, give. If you cannot give $100, if you cannot even $1, maybe this dollar will make your scale heavy in the day of judgment. You don't know. With ikhlas, maybe the $100 you give, it will make your scale heavy in the day of judgment. May Allah Azza wa Jalla accept your amal. May Allah reward the committee of this masjid, the president of this masjid, the committee of this masjid. And by the way, brother, mashallah, Jail Akhtar, jazahullahu khairan. From the Hajj, he gave me well long time ago. May Allah accept, inshallah, his amal. May Allah reward the Imam Rauf, mashallah, this Mubarak man, he's not here. Always when I am here, always he pushed me to be Imam. May Allah reward him. May Allah reward our best Qari, mashallah, Sheikh Fuad al-Qassas. May Allah give barakah in him and his family. May Allah Everyone gave tonight sadaqah, may Allah replace it with khair for him. And every brother and sister cannot give sadaqah, may Allah give him rizq al-halal and give him barakah in his life, inshallah. Jazakum Allah salam jaza. But please, ya ikhwan, please, please, let me just tell you something important. Wallahi, very important. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, how many of you still listening to me? Raise your hands. Let me see. You see, half of you not listening. You see, half of you not listening. Yes. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by Allah al-Azim, the man snatched his sadaqah between the jars of 70 shaitan. So don't think when you raise your hand and you give sadaqah, do you think it's easy? It's not easy. And you know, it's more difficult when you go home and you start looking at the pledge and say, what made me do this? You know. So ya ikhwan, when you raise your hand, be careful. There is 70 shaitan will gather around you to push you away, not to fulfill your pledge. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu awfu bil uqud. Please write your name, your phone number, bring us the papers. Jazakallah khair. We will communicate with you and we'll make the arrangement. Jazakumullah ahsan jaza. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
السلام علیکم ورحمت اللہ. دل کی گہرائی سے آپ سب کا بہت بہت شکریہ, اور خاص طور پہ آپ کی یہاں کی جو کمیٹی کے ساتھی ہیں, وقار صاحب, رشید بھائی آپ کا, علی ہاشمی صاحب آپ کا, اور تمام جو نمازی حضرات آئے, آپ سب کا بہت بہت شکریہ. وقت کیونکہ کم ہے اور گھروں کو بھی جانا ہوگا آپ لوگوں کو, تو میں نے سوچا کہ کیونکہ یہ اتنی اچھی جماعت ساتھیوں کی بیٹھی ہے, آپ کو جانے سے پہلے ایک نشید سنا دیں. ٹھیک ہے, میرے ساتھ امجد بھائی بھی ہیں اور میرا اپنا دوست خالد بھی ہے, وہ بھی انشاءاللہ ان سے بھی ایک ایک نشید سن لیں گے, ایک آپ کو میں سنا دیتا ہوں. ٹھیک, کون سی سنیں گے؟ کچھ یاد ہے؟ الہی تیری چوکھٹ پر محمد کا روزہ, میرے نبی پیارے نبی. اچھا, اچھا, any Bengali brothers over here? Yeah, how many Bengali brothers? One, two, any more? Two brothers only? Three brothers. Just because our Bengali brothers are also here, I will also read a nasheed in Bangla for you. How do you like that? Allah bless you. Any of my brothers from India as well? Raise your hands. India se hain? Aapke liye Hindi mein bhi padh denge. We'll read it. Are India bhi to hamara hi hai yaar. Kiska hai? Hamara hai.
Mere Nabi Pyare Nabi, mere nabi pyare nabi, sunnat teri duniya di, ae nabi pyare nabi, sunnat teri duniya di, tu hi shafaat ki ama, ae rahmatul lil alamin, ae nabi pyare nabi, mere nabi pyare nabi, koi nahi tujhsa nahi, ae rahmatul lil alamin, ae nabi pyare nabi, baade saba unko bata is dard ki hai kya dawa, main to mariz ishq hoon, degi shafa unki ata, ae nabi pyare nabi, mere nabi pyare nabi, sunnat teri duniya di, koi nahi tujhsa nahi, ae rahmatul lil alamin, ae nabi pyare nabi.
آپ کیا بولیں گے سب؟ کیا بولیں گے؟ جزاک اللہ. کیا بولیں گے؟ شاباش.
ہے رسول بجھی نہ امی, ہے رسول بجھی نہ امی, রেখে চোপেতে মোরে কোন সুতোয় তুমি, রেখে চোপেতে মোরে কোন সুতো, জানি না গোপনে কেমন করে, জানি না গোপনে কেমন করে হৃদয় গড়েছ প্রেমের বলয়, হে রসুল হে রসুল বুঝি না আমি, হে রসুল তোমারি নামে আনন্দে দুলি, তোমারি নামে দুনিয়া ভুলি, কি জাদু রাখাই নামে তে তোমারি নামে আনন্দে দুলি, তোমারি নামে দুনিয়া ভুলি, কি জাদু রাখাই নামে তে কুদারি পরশে যে নাম আরশে, কুদারু পরশে যে নাম আরশে, নাম মোহাম্মদ শুধু মধুময়, হে রসুল বুঝি না আমি, হে রসুল ইলাহি তেরি চৌখট পর ভিকারি বন কে আয়া হুঁ, ইলাহি তেরি চৌখট পর ভিকারি বন কে আয়া হুঁ, সরাপা ফক্র হুঁ ইজ্জো নদামত সাথ লায়া হুঁ, ভিকারি বো কে জিসকে পাস ঝোলি হ্যা প্যালা হ্যা, ভিকারি বো জিসে হিরসো হবস নে মার ডালা হ্যা, মতায়ে দীন ও দানিশ নফস কে হাথো সে লুটবা কর, সুকুনে কলব কি দৌলত হবস কি ভেট চড়বা কর, লুটা কর সারি পুঁজি গফলতো اس یہاں کی دل دل میں سہارا لینے آیا ہوں, تیرے کعبے کے آنچل میں یہ آنکھیں خشک ہیں, یا رب انہیں رونا نہیں آتا, سلگتے داغ ہیں دل میں جنہیں دھونا نہیں آتا, الہی تیری چوکھٹ پر بھکاری بن کے آیا ہوں.
ٹھیک ہے جی, لو بھائی سناؤ, ایک تم سناؤ پھر ہم سے بھائی سے.
ہر خطا پہ شرمسار ہوں میں, اے خدایا گناہگار ہوں میں, جان کر بھول کر جو کیا ہے, ہے پتا مجھ کو اس کی سزا ہے, تیری چوکھٹ پہ سر نہ جھکایا, بس زمانے کو اپنا بنایا, تیری نعمت ہی تو آسرا ہے تجھ سے کہنے کو کچھ نہ بچا ہے میرے سجدوں پہ ایسی نظر کر میں اندھیروں میں ہوں تو سحر کر ان دعاؤں میں ایسا اثر دے رب کعبہ مجھے معاف کر دے رب کعبہ مجھے معاف کر دے نیکیوں سے مجھے جوڑ دے تو پھر میرا رخ ادھر موڑ دے تو ایسا رستہ مجھے تو دکھا ہر خطا پہ شرم سار ہوں میں اے خدایا گناہگار ہوں میں ان دعاؤں میں ایسا سر دے رب کعبہ مجھے معاف کر دے ماں سے بڑھ کے ہے پیار تیرا اور تیرے سوا کون میرا گر نہ جاؤں مجھے تو اٹھا ہر خطا پہ شرم سار ہوں میں اے خدایا گناہگار ہوں میں میرے سجدوں پہ ایسی نظر کر میں اندھیروں میں ہوں تو سحر کر میرے آنسو سوالی ہیں تیرے گر رہے ہیں یہ دامن پہ میرے اب تو سن لے میری اے خدا ہر خطا پہ شرم سار ہوں میں اے خدایا گناہگار ہوں میں ان دعاؤں میں ایسا سر دے رب کعبہ مجھے معاف کر دے رب کعبہ مجھے معاف کر دے
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ چند اشعار بارگاہ رسالت صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم
سلام اس پر سلام اس پر کے جس نے بے قصوں کی دستگیری کی سلام اس پر کے جس نے بادشاہی میں فقیری کی سلام اس پر کے اسرار محبت جس نے سمجھائے سلام اس پر کے جس نے زخم کھا کر پھول برسائے سلام اس پر کے جس نے زخم کھا کر پھول برسائے سلام اس پر جو سچائی کی خاطر دکھ اٹھاتا آتا تھا سلام اس پر جو بھوکا رہ کے اوروں کو کھلاتا تھا سلام اس پر جو بھوکا رہ کے اوروں کو کھلاتا تھا سلام اس پر کے جس کے گھر میں چاندی تھی نہ سونا تھا سلام اس پر کے ٹوٹا بوریا جس کا بچھونا تھا سلام اس پر کے جس نے خون کے پیاسوں کو کبائیں دی سلام اس پر کے جس نے گالیاں سن کر دعائیں دی سلام اس پر کے جس نے گالیاں سن کر دعائیں دی سلام اس پر کے جس نے فضل کے موتی بکھیرے ہیں سلام اس پر بروں کو جس نے فرمایا یہ میرے ہیں سلام اس پر بروں کو جس نے فرمایا یہ میرے ہیں سلام اس پر کے جس نے بے قصوں کی دستگیری کی سلام اس پر کے جس نے بادشاہی میں فقیری کی
شکریہ السلام علیکم
اللهم لك الحمد كما انت احلو فصلي على محمد كما انت احلو وافعل بنا ما انت احلو فانك اهل التقوى واهل المغفره رب لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك اللهم لا احصي الثناء عليك انت كما اثنيت على نفسك يا اول الاولين يا اخر الاخرين يا ذا القوه المتين يا راحم المساكين يا ارحم الراحمين ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد اذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمه انك انت الوهاب ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم افتح لنا أبواب رحمتك اے اللہ یہ جتنے حاضرین مجلس ہیں ہم سب کے اگلے پچھلے چھوٹے بڑے تمام گناہوں کو معاف فرما اے اللہ اولاد کو نیک و صالح بنا ان کو ہماری آنکھوں کی ٹھنڈک بنا صاف ستھری حلال وسعت والی روزی نصیب فرما اس کو اپنے راستے میں خرچ کرنے کی توفیق عطا فرما مالک الملک الجلال والاکرام جو خیریں تیرے حبیب نے تجھ سے مانگی وہ تمام کی تمام ہمیں عطا فرما اور جن شرور سے آپ نے خود پناہ مانگی ان تمام شرور سے اے اللہ ہمیں بھی پناہ عطا فرما بیماروں کو صحت شفاء کاملہ نصیب فرما قرض داروں کے قرض ادا فرما بے اولادوں کو صالح نرین اولاد عطا فرما ربنا تقبل منا انک انت السمیع العلیم وتب علینا انک انت التواب الرحیم وصلی اللہ تعالی علی خیر خلقہ محمد وآلہ واصحابہ اجمعین برحمتک یا ارحم الراحمین
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brother and sister, jazakallahu khair for coming. The sister food arrangement is in the basement. Sisters, please proceed to the basement. And the brothers' food arrangement is on the first floor. All the brothers are requested to proceed downstairs, please. Jazakallahu khair.
Thank you.